You know, I for one cannot believe that the son of Claude Lemieux, one of the dirtiest players in National Hockey League history, went out there and bit a guy. In fact, it's actually something that sort of runs in the family, doesn't it? Here's an article on the Toronto Sun from 2014, 8 of the best bites in sports history. And legendary NHL agitator Claude Lemieux is on this list. He did everything he could to throw his opponents off their game. During the 86 Stanley Cup Finals, the Montreal Canadiens forward got into a fight with Calgary Flames forward Jim Peplinski. Lemieux scratched Peplinski's hand and proceeded to bite his finger. The Flames forward showed the referee, and the ref said, "How do I know you didn't do this to yourself?" He then got a tetanus shot and jabbed the league by saying, "I didn't know they allowed cannibalism in the NHL." That was in 1986. Give it, what's the math on that? Okay, so 5, 91, 15, 2001, and then give it 35 years, and all of a sudden we have ourselves a situation involving the son of one Claude Lemieux and the son of one Keith Tkachuk, who hadn't been involved in this biting thing back in 86, but who is still noted as one of the more agitative NHL players in NHL history, too. The Sens and the Kings yesterday. It's a third period scrum in the corner where forwards Brady Tkachuk and forwards Brendan Lemieux kind of get into it a little bit. They fall down, get taken down to the ice, and you can see as Brady Tkachuk has his hands all shoved in there to Brendan Lemieux's face, Lemieux kind of pushes himself forward, he gets his chompers out, and he takes a bite. In fact, he takes two bites. Brady Tkachuk gets out of the scrum. He looks horrified as he's talking to the referee, trying to point out, "Hey, the guy bit me." He's showing off his hand. He's showing off two parts of his hand. And then even in the penalty box, you could see the guy just looks like he has seen The Thing on repeat a few times. I've never seen Brady Tkachuk look this horrified at something that happened on the ice before, but it happened here. The guy gets absolutely shook. He shows the referee, "Yo, the guy bit me. Here's blood." Both of the guys receive 4-minute double minors for roughing, while Lemieux receives a 5-minute match penalty for the bite as well. After the game, you had yourselves the quote from Brady Tkachuk that was just absolutely beautiful. Like, you know, I've always said that the Tkachuks have great interviews. This is probably one of those. Tkachuk was furious. "This is the one time I'm going to answer this," said Brady. "It was the most gutless thing somebody could ever do. This guy, you can ask any one of his teammates, nobody ever wants to play with this guy. This guy is a bad guy and a bad teammate. He focuses on himself all the time. The guy's just a joke. He shouldn't be in the NHL. This guy's gutless. No other team wants him. He's going to keep begging to be in the NHL, but no other team is going to want him. He's an absolute joke. I can't even wrap my head around it. People don't do this. He's just a bad guy. It's outrageous. Kids don't even do that anymore. Babies do that. I don't even know what he was thinking. He's just a complete brickhead. He's got nothing up there. Bad guy, bad player, but what a joke he is," said Brady Tkachuk. And yeah, what a quote, eh? Brady Tkachuk absolutely goes in on Brendan Lemieux. And, you know, we don't even care about the score of the hockey game anymore. We don't care that the LA Kings actually won that game with a score of 4-2. Nobody cares about that. Nobody cares about the result. Nobody cares about, you know, the goals and everything. Everybody has their eyes on this Lemieux and Tkachuk thing. And I made it a very specific point to open this video up by saying, yeah, the guy's dad did a similar thing back in 86. I mean, the apple doesn't fall too far from the tree, does it not? And Brendan Lemieux, Claude Lemieux, we all kind of know what Claude's reputation was like in the National Hockey League. Sure, he was an effective player at scoring points, but the guy was one of the most, like, disliked players in the league for a reason. Meanwhile, his son Brendan, carrying this reputation where apparently teams don't want to go out there and nobody wants to play with this guy. Let's go over a few other tweets that highlight just that idea. The immediate reply to this Bruce Garriott quote on Brady Tkachuk is from Keith Olbermann. He says that Lemieux's reputation was absolutely that in New York, wherein people didn't want to play with this guy, he was a bad guy and a bad teammate. You then have a few replies talking about how apparently Brendan Lemieux was traded away from a good junior team for futures as his teammates all hated him. And the Manitoba Moose too. Here's a tweet from Scott Wheeler. The part about how Lemieux is disliked around the league, including how his own locker rooms don't like him, it's true, by the way. A real brickhead. Here's another quote from Jacob Stoller. While Brendan Lemieux was with the Manitoba Moose, I witnessed him pelt pucks at Eric Comrie's head for fun in practice, and punch a high-ranking Moose staffer in the nuts before leaving for Christmas break. He doesn't say anything else, but he kind of just leaves this stuff on the table. And I saw a whole bunch of people memeing about this situation after it happened. Oh, we're going to get a new episode of the Watch Your Tone podcast with Tony D'Angelo and Brendan Lemieux immediately after this. I think it was Mr. Booth who said something like that. But now, today, we have ourselves the news that LA Kings forward Brendan Lemieux has been offered an in-person hearing via Zoom for biting Ottawa's Brady Tkachuk. The date and time are to be determined. Because this is now going to be an in-person hearing, well, technically a virtual meeting if you want to say it's going to be over Zoom, but according to Elliot Friedman, this opens up the potential of Lemieux actually getting suspended for more than 5 games. Because it is now an in-person hearing, that is an allowable conclusion. Now, whether or not that's going to happen, who really knows? He might just get a fine for $5,000 because everybody gets a fine for $5,000. Who really knows? But I don't know. Like, we'll see. The NHL hasn't dealt with anything like this in a very long time. In fact, I don't even know. Like, the last time somebody bit a guy in the National Hockey League, was it Brendan Lemieux's dad in the 80s? I really don't know my history of the NHL and its players biting others, but we do know that when it comes to very bad mouth-to-body part interactions, I shouldn't have said it like that. Brad Marchand and the licking, that's probably the most notable one in most people's minds. Super unsanitary, super dirty, and like, just what are you doing kind of stuff. Even now, with the pandemic going around, you know, everybody's talking about masks and your saliva and all that stuff. I mean, of course, you know, even without a pandemic, biting somebody is not great, but especially in this kind of environment, you have a much bigger reason to not go out there spreading your saliva around. And for Brady Tkachuk, I mean, there's a reason the guy looked super terrified immediately after the scrum happened. I mean, it's not fun getting bit when you're not expecting it, especially when it's good enough to draw blood. Here's the picture that I saw on Reddit of Tkachuk trying to talk to the referee. Look at that. That's a gusher right there. I'll tell you this, I think everybody kind of knows what it's like to bite your own hands, right? We all did this as a child. But like, in order to bite your hands to the point where there is blood, you gotta really like get in there. And there's a part of you that kind of holds back when you're trying to pry open your flesh with your teeth. So for a guy to get this kind of sensation from somebody else where there is no internal holding back of the mind, where the mind says, okay, we can't bite down too hard because we're gonna break the skin. Like, I could only imagine how painful that must have been to get bit to the point where there is indeed blood, especially in that position there. It's so weird, dude. This is the biggest story in the NHL right now, is it? I don't know. Probably is? I mean, the licking thing for Marchand was huge when it happened, so I guess it makes sense. And the entire Claude Lemieux biting somebody in 86, and then 35 years later, his son bites somebody again, who happens to be Keith Tkachuk's kid, and then there was a video circling around of Keith Tkachuk and Claude Lemieux fighting it out back when these guys were in their heyday, and it's like, okay, there's a good amount of hockey history that has been presented in the past few hours here, and it's all started because of this biting incident. So talk to me in the comments if you're a Kings fan, if you're a Sens fan, about Brendan Lemieux, his reputation around the NHL. Is Brady Tkachuk in the right to call the guy out like this? And, I mean, okay, I'm trying to sell this point as a contention for, like, discussion over here, but I think everybody kind of has the same opinion, right? He can't be biting people in the NHL. Probably not a good idea. So, talk to me in the comments. What do you think about this entire situation? I hope you enjoyed this one for Rosén99. A link will be in the description to that article I was reading on the Toronto Sun, because it actually is pretty interesting how often biting people happens throughout the world of sports. This article is from 2014, and this Claude Lemieux thing is one of only 8 stories that are listed in the article. One of the more notable ones as well, it's Alex Burrows and Patrice Bergeron back in the 2011 Stanley Cup Finals. And you know, if I'm gonna go out there and start comparing and contrasting bites, at least Bergeron still had his glove on when Burrows bit him, so yeah. I already said the outro, so I'm just gonna leave you here with an and bye.